Get ready to match the stars. David Doyle, Brett Summers, Charles Dobson Riley, from The Price is Right, Holly Hallstrom, McLean Stevenson, and Betty White, as we play the star-studded big money match game. And now, here's the star of match game, Gene Roberts.
Okay, John, thank you. Thank you for joining us. If you're all quite ready, we'll have a go at it.
I don't think it's fair.
What?
I'm sitting around in a lot of old cheap schmatters that have spots on the bottom and ink marks, and you're in all those swell clothes.
Well, I've tried to give the show some class.
Well,
that's my function.
Well, clothes-wise, you're not doing bad. Otherwise,
the problem is, some of us are wealthier than others. Some of us have clothes to wear, Brett. You can't, you mustn't. Some poor folk don't have any clothes to wear.
That's me.
The best picture of your nephew I've ever seen.
That's not my nephew, Charles. That's me.
Let me see. Oh, I'd recognize that bum anywhere.
Charles said he challenged my ability as a windsurfer.
You know, it's a shame they already cast Tarzan, Gene. I think he'd had a good shot.
There's Gene on a surfboard, a windsurfboard, just to prove that I could do it.
Look
in case you want to get
legs.
A shot of it. There it is.
Projection is
well, you
wonderful.
Can't tell, but that's me, windsurfing. Buddy. Great sport. Thank you. Hello, Steve and Jocelyn.
Hi.
This is Steve Southern and Jocelyn Casey over here, and we welcome you and wish you the best. Now, Steve, tell us about you.
I'm a film student at UCLA, and I work part-time for writer and part-time for psychologist, and I live here in Los Angeles, down at the beach.
The writer and a psychologist. Is that the same person? Or
No, they're different people.
They are. You're going to get into filmmaking? Is that it?
Hopefully, someday.
Yeah. You know it's an overcrowded profession, don't you?
Believe me, I know how overcrowded it is.
Yes. The rate of unemployment is 96%. You're aware of that, aren't you?
You're depressing me here.
Yes.
I know.
Chance, you may be a very gifted person. Chance of lightning striking you is very remote. Keep trying, Steve.
Great letters.
Thank you.
All right, Jocelyn, tell us about you.
I'm an out-of-work actress, model, and dancer.
Oh, there's another one.
And and I have a twin sister.
I think you got a better chance than he has.
I have a twin,
you have a twin sister.
Uh-huh. And she lives next door to me in Belmont Shores.
Yeah.
And...
is she here today?
No, she's in North Carolina. She won a dance scholarship. So she's out there. She just is dancing hard away.
You live in Belmont Shores?
Yes.
Where is that?
It's in between Seal Beach and Long Beach.
Oh, yes.
And right. I sail and surf and ride my motorcycle.
Would you like to see me on a windsurfboard?
Yes. I haven't tried that yet.
It's a lot of fun. Got to try that. Very difficult. Steve, you have a choice of A or B.
A, please.
Thank you. Here we go. The bride said it was a mistake marrying a jockey. At our wedding, instead of a veil, he made me wear a blank. Yeah, the bride said it was a mistake marrying a jockey. At our wedding, instead of a veil, he made me wear a...
saddle.
Saddle.
Back in the saddle again.
Go ahead, David.
Did he say shuttle?
Saddle.
Saddle. Saddle. Yeah. Saddle. It is.
Oh, that's it. Very good.
Saddle.
Is the speaker now working?
Beg your pardon?
I guess it's not.
Now, we have a little speaker on here that shoots right up my leg and just terrifies me. I think somebody's making a move on me.
She
I can't
loves
see
it.
Them.
Is
his name Southwind?
Southard. S-O-U-T-H-A-R-D.
Oh,
Southard.
Golly, I wish my eyes were better. I think I'm going to have to get my new glasses. Oh, no, I didn't say any of that stuff. I said a bridle and a bit in my mouth.
Bridle and a bit in my mouth. Uh-huh.
The thing that goes around a Eden, a horse feeder.
A horse feeder. All right.
What do you call
that? Just the tip.
A feed bag.
Yeah.
Right. All right. It was a mistake marrying a jockey. Instead of a veil, he made me wear a...
well, if you got the horse, well, I got the saddle.
That's not what he had in mind.
But it was correct.
Yes,
and
it was
my mother
indeed.
Loves it when I'm correct on this show.
She does?
Yes.
Yeah.
Does your mother know what you're wearing?
No. Here's the thing, friends. You may see her as you do in the tight shots... you know, just from, like, here up. And she looks as if she's not wearing much. And but if you can see her from the waist down, I mean, if you want to see a long-stemmed American beauty, Rose, you've got to see this. Hey, there you are, America. Don't go. Roger, put the card down so I can see the monitor and see what I'm doing, you dingbat. Okay, thank you very much, Holly.
It is an overcrowded field, and I wish you would explain that to Holly.
Yes, but I'm working.
You're darn right.
McLean?
I don't care about your dumb show, Gene. I mean, this is not my life, you know what I mean?
Yeah, right.
Well, anyway, I want to do the best I can for old Steve and his career. Since so many of us on the panel are working, I put saddle.
Oh, good. Here's the Steve. Do I see a frown on your face?
I am sorry, Steve. I was more in the not being a leg person. I'm more in the face person. When you said instead of a veil, a set of blinders.
A blinders. No one said halter. Halter is one.
And bridal suite is
bridal
another.
Bridal would have been
don't
another.
Don't call me sweet.
I said bridal.
We're in enough trouble with the shorts. You don't want a halter, too.
All right. Jocelyn, here it is. Dick said, you know you've had too much to drink at the bar when instead of coins, you find yourself stuffing blanks into the cigarette machine.
There is no answer to this question. Trust me.
Dick said, you know you've had too much to drink at the bar when instead of coins, you find yourself stuffing blanks into the cigarette machine.
Matches?
Matches. Yeah. Well, it was at a bar, remember, Jocelyn. What would you find at a bar?
Well, of course you would find matches, but I mean, there's such a plethora of things that one might stuff into a cigarette machine. I had to go with ice cubes.
Ice cubes. That's okay.
That's pretty drunk.
I told you there was no answer to this question.
I said, are you going to do Sidney Greenstreet for us today?
No,
and everything? And other coasters.
Coasters, all right. They look like large coins.
Maybe the next time he'll do Sidney
Coasters.
All right, that's two of those. All right, Holly, instead of coins, you know yourself you have too much to drink when you find yourself stuffing blanks into the cigarette machine.
When you're just stuffing dollars into the cigarette machine. Yeah.
You have an ulterior motive, McLean.
That was a really good answer. I'm really looking forward to this week.
Well, I was going to go with Susan B. Anthony, but I thought that might be a bit esoteric for the most.
Yeah, well, see, that would make sense, though, because they are coins. And if you're drunk, you would take olives, coasters, matches.
Well, we've discussed this now before, Gene. You know I do not partake of alcoholic beverages except on certain occasions. Minimally. But then I do it so good.
I bet you do. All right, McLean.
We don't need all that information, do we?
Why not? Why not?
Okay, the question again was...
The question again was, you know you had too much drink at the bar when instead of coins, you find yourself stuffing blanks into the cigarette machine.
Exactly. That's the question that I addressed this to, which was bottle caps.
Oh, bottle caps. Wonderful answer.
Thank you.
Wonderful answer.
Nifty, huh?
I turned my back for a week or so on the show,
right.
And you men just get silly.
Oh, no.
It's ridiculous.
No, we're not getting silly, are we?
One little girl wears just a rather brief... Oh, I needed that. Now, I don't partake either, but somebody has told me that there are olives...
Olives! An excellent response. So there we are at the end of round one. 3-0 score in favor of Steve. Round two coming up after this. Now we'll carry on to round two. Steve, you're ahead. You have to go first.
A, please.
A it is. All right. Ron said it's strange going to a school for masochists.
Ah.
Every day we have blank and tell. Have you got one? You can probably sell it up there. All right, Steve, here we go. Ron said, it's strange going to a school for masochists. Every day we have blank and tell.
Hurt and tell?
Hurt and tell, he said. I don't know whether that's going to work for you or not, and you don't either, do you? Brett, what'd you say?
Oh, you didn't even have to play.
Oh, I didn't have to play.
I said self-flagellation and tell.
Self-flagellation and tell.
Isn't that a good answer,
I think,
darling?
It's splendid.
Well, I think you should state that.
Yes, oh, it's splendid, right.
Whip and tell.
Whip and tell is good.
Better than self-flagellation?
The same thing. What'd you say, Miss Betty?
Music lover that I am, the whip and tell overture.
Whip and tell overture. Whip seems to have been the response. Now, Jocelyn, you need 3 to tie and 4 to win. The old lady who lived in a shoe said, I decided that I'd like to do some traveling. That's why I sold the shoe and moved into a blank.
The veteran.
Come on, write something, David. This guy can only play so long.
All right, Brett. Here we go. Oh. The old lady who lived in a shoe said, I decided that I'd like to do some traveling. That's why I sold the shoe and moved into a blank.
Roller skate?
Perfect. That's a good answer. She came up with the perfect response.
Yes, she did. Darn her. Very good, darling. I put that slipper. I know.
Most pathetic award for 1981, Charles. You couldn't think of roller skate either?
No, darling. But then again, I have other virtues. No, it is the most pathetic
award. You're sad. They don't award those awards unless there's a meaning to it.
A canoe. Yes. Well, yes, go ahead. Feel free.
You want to boo her? Give her a boo.
Give it a boo.
Crocodile tears. Fake tears.
Oh, he told me she liked booze.
There it is. That's one for her. All right, Holly. The old lady lived in a shoe, decided she wanted to travel, so she moved into a...
She just boogied along on her roller skate.
Roller skate. Sorry, 3-2 now. You going to help the little lady along?
I was going to try. I've now gotten my brain back into the game.
Right.
Off of...
Because she's a very pretty girl. She deserves some assistance from
I know that.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, this ain't, cream cheese over here, pal.
Yes.
I'm on target with Sneaker.
Aha!
I'm so glad.
All right, show us your roller skates, Betty.
All right.
There's a roller skate. So, we got a little tie game here. That means we go to the tiebreaker. We'll turn these lights off. One question for each. The one who matches the most will be the winner. Steve, you go first.
B, please.
B it is. Harry said, no wonder that cowboy walks like that. He's wearing rawhide blanks.
Game going on here, boys and girls.
There certainly is.
I mean.
Nothing to be ashamed of.
Harry said, no wonder that cowboy walks like that. He's wearing rawhide blanks.
Undershorts.
Yeah! Undershorts. All
right. I don't know why I said roller skates to this one. Sure.
Finally, David gets one in a row.
Daughter of Short.
All right, Jockey Short. That's 2 for Steve.
Short.
That's 3 for him. We'll pass you because you've already showed us your shorts. All right, show and tell.
Shorts,
right.
I'm not touching any short jokes. I just All right. short, that's it.
Gotcha. All right, sir.
Okay, whip it out and let him see it, right?
Right.
Jockey Short.
Jockey Short. 5.
Jockey Shorts, or as they're known in the trade, seat cover.
So you'll have a little catching up to do. The best you'll be able to do when we come back is to tie it. Let's see how that goes later. Now then. Now we'll go to the other tie-breaking question. Jocelyn has one shot at it. I hope you'll give her your maximum effort. Here
I
it is.
I will.
Dumb Donald the Sailor is really dumb. Not bad. The only job he could get on a ship is as a blank.
Speaking of that, Dumb Donald the Sailor is really dumb. The only job he could get
That's
on a
it.
Ship
These
is...
These two people
oh,
got
oh,
it just
I
like
got
that.
It,
great
honey,
minds.
I got it. Look at this.
Is this... I'm not a naughty boy, but is this not a term for a... on a ship?
Very obscure. Everybody ready? Here it is. Dumb Donald the Sailor is really dumb. The only job he could get on a ship is as a blank.
Sweeping the deck?
Sweeping the deck.
I'm glad I wasn't the only one
well,
who got it wrong.
I don't think that's going to come up over here. David had a brilliant idea, and it was unlikely that anyone was going to match him.
But it is a terrible
job. There's
a
device made out of old polystyrene or something like that. In the shape of a large sausage, and when you pull up to a dock, you hang it over the side of the boat so that
when it hits the
when
dock,
it hits the dock,
take all the damage.
Right, and it's called a
fender.
Right,
that was his job.
The right,
honey, what was the sign?
What the rest of you have there? A sail, an anchor, a what?
Dumb Donald, the dock.
Come on down, Steve. Now, Jocelyn, this thing is going to turn around, and you will hold your seat, and it'll take you backstage for a little while. We'll see you later for game number two. Bye. Hello there. Here we go with the big money. Good luck to you, Steve. We polled the studio audience and said write down your best answer to this. Blank do. Blank do. All right?
Betty.
I do. I mean, I do.
I do.
Are you
well, we know that.
Charles?
What is she singing?
You hear a hint? Howdy do.
Howdy do?
Howdy do, well, okay.
All right, you got two now.
McLean.
Is what?
Doo doo.
There's one we're
it's
not
good,
getting.
McLean, don't knock it.
Is there a big one we're not getting?
What'll I do?
I didn't think you could say doo-doo. That's
tacky. You initiated
That's
that
tacky.
Word into this show 9 years ago.
I
no
know.
One ever said it until you said it. 9 years ago, you said doo-doo.
We've
on
come
the dog made doo-doo in the back seat
Make
of the car.
Doo-doo.
You said that. I
Television
remember that.
Television has come a long way because just last week somebody said caca. Yeah. I'm not going to sit here and use doo-doo.
Doo-doo-doo-wah,
I'm going to say is we do on there? Because I don't want to use it if it is.
We do?
So I'm saying you do. Just give the kid the money, will you?
What's your response?
My response is you do.
You do?
You got it.
Who do?
You do.
Oh,
Who
I do?
You got it.
Okay, yeah, well, I will if I get a chance. All right. So you got you do, I do, and howdy do. You want one of those, or can you think of something better?
I think I'll go with I do.
I do. There you go. All right, Robin. All right. Let's see if I do is under the $100 response. Can do
sure.
is there.
Can do.
No one said that. All right, the next one says, how do you do? Well, that was okay. Charles said that. Very good.
And he said, howdy do.
Well, this would have matched close enough. Last chance for I do. Here it is. Yes, it is. Very good. She would have preferred it if you had kissed her on the lips instead of on the cheek. All right. Now, we're going to do a little message for you, America, Steve, and then we'll see how much you'll win after this. All right. Do we just have time to say goodbye in a gracious way? Goodbye graciously.
Goodbye graciously.
Bye. Bye. Graciously.
Splendid Bye. Seeing Thank all you. Of
hey,
you.
Hey, listen. Thank
what?
Good night, Don't Grace. Forget to tune in tomorrow to see if this guy wins big bucks.
Oh, all right.
Hey, was that
Thank
a,
you. A Forgot flagola? About that. Gene Rayburn here. Tune in tomorrow to see who wins big bucks. Goodbye.
Today's contestants will also receive a beautiful jewelry ensemble in the Golden Manor of Monet, designed and crafted by Monet, the master jeweler. And Trident Sugarless Gum, the great-tasting sugarless gum with fire flavors, including bubblegum Trident for families who care about their teeth. And the new shape of pleasure, light, sparkling, boldly sophisticated pink champagne, takes you away from the ordinary pink champagne malt liquor from Iroquois brands. And Niagara, as America's number one spray starch, helps prevent the deep penetration of soil and sting. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Trotman production. This program is edited for broadcast.